Japanese Sound Language. Today we'll be learning about onomatope. If you've already been in Japan, you might have discovered that the Japanese use these weird words as their adjectives to describe things. And I will present to you the five most used ones here in Japan. And don't try to use them abroad somewhere else than Japan, because they sound really weird. Now the first one is pika pika. The meaning is when you clean something up and, I don't know, you tell your parents that your room is really pika pika. It means that it's beautiful, that it's very nicely cleaned up. But I don't know what Pikachu wants to say with that. The next one is kuru kuru. It means rotating or turning like that. Or if you have a headache, you can also say my head is kuru kuru, atama kuru kuru, and they will understand you. It's everything that's for turning. You can just say kuru kuru instead of the real word for rotating, which is mawaru. The next one is kira kira. It's a little bit like pika pika, just that it's a little bit more beautiful in the sense of that it's shiny. It's like really sparkling. They say it when you have like that shiny makeup that the Japanese use a lot, or something like that. For instance, you would say my hair is pika pika, but you wouldn't say my room is kira kira, because otherwise your hair would be way too shiny, way too bright, whatever. So be careful when you use pika pika and kira kira. They're a little bit different. Do you know Japanese mochi sweets? Well, the next one is for you. Number two is mochi mochi. This comes from the Japanese sweet mochi, and you can basically use it for everything that is kind of spongy. For example, this cake, it's fufu, it's not hard. So yeah, they say it's mochi mochi. So the number one onomatope that is used in Japan is gucha gucha. It basically means that you put something in disorder. You can also use bosa bosa, but it's a little bit different, so you might want to use gucha gucha all the time. It's like you take a paper and make it gucha gucha. You see that all these sounds, they kind of sound a little bit like what you would do. And when you come to Japan and get used to these words, you will find yourself using them pretty fast, because they're just so useful. And when you don't know the adjective to use, you just use the sound that a thing makes when it gets gucha gucha, whatever. So that's a really easy way to communicate Japanese. So that was it for today's lesson. Try to say onomatope by yourself, and try to use these things when you come to Japan. I hope you learned something useful, and I will see you the next time on my channel. See you!